rimo kwezo rero umusharuro wabasa kuzahiga.
World Food Day is held annually on 16th October and it is dedicated to tackling global hunger and promoting food security. At this year's celebrations in Rubanda District, the Minister for Agriculture, Vincent Sempija, expressed concern about the poor farming methods in many of Uganda's hilly areas, which have led to severe soil erosion.
You can see that people migrate from Kigezi because of land fragmentation, you know, lack of land. We are trying to change the methods of production here.
Sempija highlighted what needs to be done in order to ensure maximum agricultural production in hilly areas.
We can use intensive farming, we can use small areas, but produce enough for our families and enough for selling.
The minister emphasized the need to compel farmers to abide by the bylaws on farming practices.
We are going to use the bylaws and the laws that are available to fight this soil erosion. People must abide by approved methods of farming so that we protect our land.
At the same function, President Museveni, through a speech read by the second Deputy Prime Minister, Kirunda Chivejinja, said the country is generally food secure.
The country and the population is food secure. 83% said for a few pockets of food insecurity.
We have decided to have taxes from agricultural inputs to assist farmers gain access to inputs at fair prices. We have also decided to restructure NADS with Operation Wealth Creation to improve its efficiency.
Local leaders have, however, blamed government for ignoring agricultural extension services to local farmers.
The challenge we have these days, our leaders, the extension workers, the political leaders, we are not doing our best to sensitize our people to make sure that the best practice in farming are used.
According to Rosa Malango, the UN resident coordinator, more people in the world suffered from hunger in 2016 than in 2015. She attributed this to conflicts, droughts, and floods.
115 million people around the world suffered from hunger in 2016. This is an increase of 38 million people if we compare it to 2015. But the good news is that together we can do something positive and leave no one behind.